For you too, this GMR Rower. Welcome to American Truck Simulator and update 1.38. I know season 3 didn't go very well because of the beta. So today we're starting season 4. So let's get started. At the end of season 3, we were hauling a lot of gravel in the beta. That contract expired, and the video call was degraded, so that's okay. Today, season 4, we are going to be hauling our first load out of San Diego, eastbound, towards either Yuma or Centro, so we could go to the grand opening of Gallon Oil's new truck stop there. So let's get started. Okay, let's take a job. So San Diego. Files going to Yuma. And of course it's raining, so hope the contract doesn't expire by the time we get over there. 1.38, they did a lot of changes to the game. So those changes are here in Los Angeles where we're at. Other changes were done to El Centro, Vegas, Cedar City, Pinnacle, Solo, Holbrook, and also the towns of Pinnacle, Nevada, and Tremont in Utah were added to the game. On Thursday, after this video is published, Idaho will be out, and we'll be making a run up to Idaho. A lot of great stuff coming to American Truck Simulator. Turn on lights on, we don't want to get a ticket. Also, if you notice in this stream, they changed the graphics big time.
As a 1.38, we are now using a system called SSAO, which replaces the older graphics in the game. It replaces the old SSTA graphics, which came with NVIDIA. SSAO is frequently used on radar and graphics cards, like what I have on my system right now. Word of caution, if you are running mods like Jeff was in his stream, do not turn those on yet because they have not been updated. High SSAO settings will crash a game if you don't have a high-end card. Some mods are not even supported by SSAO. Okay, we're almost to the freeway. Also, you can notice they have put in new signs. In the older version of ATS, there were no signs right here. This version, there are signs. And also, these traffic lights right here, they're a lot brighter than the older version. Thank you. bulldog. One big change with 1.38 is the Mac Anthem is now an AI truck. Before that, they have not implemented them in the game yet because they just released them a couple of weeks ago. Okay, sun is starting to come up. So it's safe to turn these lights off. San Diego. And our pickup is just outside of our yard on Sutton Drive. Let's just hope that load is still there. And we just lost our load. worrying about freight market jobs. You have to be exactly in the area where the job is in game time, not real time. Or the contract will expire, you'll lose your load. Could have taken a little trucks contract. But since we're going as far as El Centro for this part, we'll take a freight market job. It's a lot quicker. Okay, yep, there's our trailer. As you can see, they redesigned the route manager also. In the old version, the icons were down at the bottom. Instead of a destination marker, you get a waypoint marker. I'll show you how that works in a bit. Okay, we pause the game, and this is the waypoint marker. Then we unpause. Then we go into map, and our destination for this first part is El Centro, and we are going here. Thank you. at their way stations. And better signage has been installed. You used to go to a certain spot and the game's AI detects the pre-pass for your truck. 1.38 pre-pass has been implemented and all way stations in the game now have pre-pass installed to warn the trucks as they approach the way station. Before 1.38, most way stations did not have pre-pass, now all of them have it. Also with this update, a big change has occurred here on Highway 8. Towards El Centro. You don't have to slow down. Although there is a sign that says you have to reduce your speed, you can keep your speed at 55 going through this pass right here. Before that, the speed went all the way down to 25. ATS realized that was too slow, so they changed it. Also, they put in better signage right here in this pass. Before that, this section went down to single lane as you went through here, and you had to go 25 miles per hour. Not good when you have a heavy truckload of goods behind you. Another thing they did was they took out that crossover interchange that was in the middle of the freeway. Now you can drive all the way through El Centro without having to cross over busy freeway traffic. Another change is El Centro has more detail. It's no longer a scenery town, it's actually a stopover city in ATS now. Before that, it was a scenery town. Okay, we're going to pull into the gallon gas station here in El Centro and get some fuel. Another feature that they put in with El Centro are these traffic lights. For that, there's a stop sign right here. There's a rest area on the right side of the freeway right here. So far, we don't have to worry about that. Okay, let's turn this off. Now on Highway 111 in El Centro, head towards the gas station. Another thing with El Centro is ATS has switched from the Euro Truck inspired paint delay system for their roads to the Snap system, which is now standard for all games. With the Snap system, you can go ahead and place a road or a rail line down without having to paint it on there, which takes longer, and you lose detail when you do that. The Snap system, you can just place it and build a town around it. Other towns that have are using the Snap system are Cedar City and Pinnica. Most recently, Vegas is using the Snap system also. Before that, they were using a system that Carfo designed. They just paint the roads and buildings and use prefabs. The problem with this is it will have black holes in the map. So with this update to ATS, no more paint. ATS has officially gone to Snap in cities. So let's go ahead and pull into that truck stop. In the old version of El Centro, the truck stop was on the right hand side. And you had to take a back road to get to it. On 1.38, they moved the truck stop to the left side of the road coming from the freeway to be the right side of you coming from Vernon. Now I'm going to show you a new feature that was implemented with 1.38, dual side refueling. In the past, what you had to do was you had to drive up to a gas pump and park on the side with a fuel hose. But with 1.38, you can fuel both sides of your truck at the same time. Watch this. Okay, that topped off both tanks. Oops. But you still have to turn to get on the CAT scale. With 1.38, all truck stops have CAT scales. Thank you. towards Phoenix. Thank you. And they closed it. Thank you. jumps into the hole.